Today is Mother's Day. There are many cancers facing the women of our lives. What can we do for early detection? What can we do to prevent it? Let's talk about it.
Healthy Mind. I'm Elizabeth Atkins, and this is my co-host, Michael Hunter. We're so excited that you joined us here on My Healthy Mind today because our goal is to help you cultivate wellness in mind, body, and spirit. We do that by showcasing real people who've triumphed over tremendous challenges in their lives by finding the strength within and getting the help that they need to heal, recover, and live their best lives. And in doing that, they serve as an inspiration to us all. We also help you by showcasing experts who can provide the tools and resources that you need to learn about certain issues that might help you and your family identify things that can help you heal and recover and live your best lives. Here on My Healthy Mind, we talk about things that people don't want to talk about, things that are taboo, like addiction, like mental illness, like obesity, like social issues such as human trafficking. So Michael, I'm so excited that we get to talk about this very special topic today.
Absolutely, and what a great day for our show because it's Mother's Day, so yes. Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you so much.
Happy Mother's Day to the mothers that are watching us today. Our show today is going to really bring to the forefront, Elizabeth, something that has touched many of our lives.
Yes.
And is very closely related to moms, unfortunately,
yes.
Sometimes.
Yes.
So I'm really looking forward to our guests. They are really giving us some information that we can all take a hold of and pass along to others,
yes.
Encourage others with, mm-hmm. And be a part of the stories of triumph.
Yes, yes. So this coming Saturday is Race for the Cure here in Detroit, and we are going to be talking with many people involved in it in ways that can help you right after this commercial break.
One more hour burns, so scared of his return that I can't sleep tonight. In this hospital life.
We have three beautiful children, and everything you do or say to me, they take pictures with their minds, and I want to put a stop to that.
Sometimes I have thoughts of killing you. You know that?
Go ahead. You're doing me a favor.
Alex was the only one that knew the secrets.
Boy, why don't you leave that girl alone for you mess around and get her pregnant?
Why do you have so many boyfriends?
They all treat me nice.
When they ever treated you to anything? Only time they come around here is when they want one thing.
No! No!
You eat so damn much, why can't you choke on something?
You're just a fat, disgusting excuse for a kid, and I ought to smack you!
I should have died instead. They were right.
No, you have. Life is worth living.
I have every type of abuse in there.
Yeah. Verbal, physical, sexual, mental.
You name it, it's in that room.
You see, after years of abuse, you lose yourself.
Miss Vivica. Miss Vivica.
Cause this time, it's the last time, I know that my eyes have seen too much. This nightmare is not fair, and I've had
I know you've been through some hell and high water, but I see a turnaround right now. You will be silent no more.
The people here actually care about you and your future and what you become after you graduate high school.
Loyola's mission is to turn out good young men.
Loyola is a place to help us grow.
A smaller setting and more one-on-one.
Give you that one-on-one attention that you don't normally get.
Making sure that the student is taken care of spiritually, educationally, and physically.
I focus more at this school than I did all my other schools.
By the time they get to about the 10th or 11th grade, they're basically bonded like brothers.
If you're looking for a brotherly love or someone to lean on or get in touch with and talk to personally, this school is the perfect place to go.
Welcome back to My Healthy Mind. We're joined today with our guest, Brian Christie, who is the co-chair of the Susan G. Komen Detroit Race for the Cure, which is this coming Saturday.
Yes, this Saturday, May 16th, is the 24th annual Susan G. Komen Detroit Race for the Cure. It's sponsored locally by Carmanis Cancer Institute. Really excited. It's been a big tradition here in the city for obviously 24 years. And this is our second year down at our location at Shane Park and Jefferson Avenue. For a number of years, a lot of people know that we were at Comerica Park and on Woodward. Well, with the M1 Rail project, last year we had to move. And so Shane Park is our new home. And so we're back for year two there. And we're really excited to see how year two goes in comparison to the first year. We kind of know different ways that we can improve things and make the experience just such a really enjoyable one for our Metro Detroit community.
And when somebody gets there at 7 a.m. Saturday, tell me some of the things that they can expect to experience.
Yeah, 7 a.m. it really kicks off. It's an early morning, but it brings out thousands of people. We expect a crowd of around 25 to 30,000. It's the second largest race event in the state behind the Detroit Marathon. So it's a huge community event. So starting at 7, there's so many different things. There's our sponsor area with all the great supporters who are helping to provide different funding and sponsorship for the Race for the Cure here in Detroit. There's a children's area. There's the Survivor Cafe, which those who are breast cancer survivors can come and really kind of form that community and that bond that they share, having that they've fought through this disease in their time and get some great information. And speaking of information, that's something that's really important is for all the guests who come on down. We get that information in their hands and let them know just what we're here to do and what the purpose is of the Race for the Cure and making sure that people know just how breast cancer is right now and affecting us, especially here in our local community.
And what is the purpose of the race?
Yeah, it's to raise funds for Susan G. Komen Breast Cancer Foundation. It's an organization that started in 1992, started with just one sister, Nancy Brinker, her promise to Susan G. Komen to do everything that she can to help fight breast cancer as she was losing her battle. Mm-hmm. And it started just in Dallas, Texas, and now it is a multinational organization with chapters all throughout the country and, like I said, in multiple countries throughout the world. We are the second largest contributor to breast cancer programs besides the national government here in the United States.
Detroit typically has a very, very strong support for Susan G. Komen, correct?
Yeah, like I mentioned, 24 years, so it's obviously been an event that has gone really, really well in the past. So we're really excited to be back for May 16th. And it really is just all part of just the fabric of our area. We call it one of the best days in the city of Detroit, that we have such a large crowd gathered. And by them, our audience coming and taking part in the race and with their donations, it goes directly to helping our local programs to help women and men that are affected by breast cancer in our tri-county area of Wayne, Oakland, and Macomb counties.
And Brian, your motivation for serving as co-chair is very special. Can you share that with us, please?
Absolutely, yeah. Like so many of us in our area, breast cancer has affected all of us and our families. My mother, back in 2003, was diagnosed with ovarian cancer. And she fought that for years and years, where it would go in remission and come back. Lengthy battle, and while she was fighting it for the fourth or fifth time, she was also diagnosed with breast cancer. And that was the summer of 2013. She passed away about 6 months later, January of 2014. So a little over a year and a half ago or so. So when that happened, you know, once you, of course, go through the natural grieving process, you do kind of have in your head, what can I do to help? What can I do to help make a difference? And luckily, this opportunity presented itself, and I'm just so happy to be part of the team and be part of this community to make sure that people understand just what they can do to help fight breast cancer and hopefully wrap up our mission of ending it.
Perfect, Brian. Thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate what you do.
Absolutely, guys. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. We'll be right back.
Stress, depression, and severe mental illness can happen to anyone. Team Mental Health Services has been helping those struggling with these conditions in southeastern Michigan. Within 24 hours of reaching out to our team, members receive psychiatric evaluations and begin the necessary treatment for recovery. Team Mental Health Services prides itself on going the extra mile for its members.
And it was towards the sixth court date. I finally stood up and said, I can handle this process the rest of the way. And it was all because of the motivation and encouragement I got from Team Mental Health staff.
Team Mental Health Services, because we care and you can.
The people here actually care about you and your future and what you become after you graduate high school.
Loyola's mission is to turn out good young men.
Loyola is a place to help us grow.
A smaller setting and more one-on-one.
Give you that one-on-one attention that you don't normally get.
Making sure that the student is taken care of spiritually, educationally, and physically.
I focus more at this school than I did all my other schools.
By the time they get to about the 10th or 11th grade, they're basically bonded like brothers.
If you're looking for a brotherly love or someone to lean on or get in touch with and talk to personally, this school is the perfect place to go.
We're back with Brian Christie, co-chair of Race for the Cure Detroit, and we are joined by a wonderful woman who has an amazing survival story. Welcome, Ellery Watkins.
Thank you.
Can you please tell us about your cancer survival story?
I was diagnosed in 1992 with stage 1 breast cancer. I had a lumpectomy, 36 treatments of radiation, and I was put on tamoxifen for 5 years. And once I was diagnosed, I made a decision that I was going to give back to my community and try to educate my fellow sisters about how important it is to do your yearly mammogram and take care of yourself. And as a result of that, I started volunteering for the Carmanis Cancer Center, and I volunteered for them for 8 years. And I've been part-time staff for 10 years. And I work with a wonderful program. It's called the BCCP program, known as the Breast and Cervical Cancer Control Program. This particular program is administered throughout all counties in Michigan. We recruit in Wayne, Oakland, and Macomb counties, but we concentrate on Wayne County because that's where one of the highest mortality rate is. We don't know if it's because they don't have insurance or they're underinsured or have high out-of-pocket costs or high deductible, but we just want to let the ladies know that this program can assist you if you have high out-of-pocket costs, no insurance at all. It gives you a pelvic, PAP, breast exam, and mammogram, and any follow-up treatment if needed.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And also part of a navigation program. We have women who are diagnosed with breast cancer, and they're treated through Carmanis, and they don't like to share it with family members. They don't want to talk to anyone. So as a navigator, we pair up with the women who are diagnosed and try to encourage them and talk to them. And it's good for someone to talk to somebody who's been through the journey.
And when you mentioned that they caught the cancer or identified it, it was because you had a mammogram. Did they consider that early detection?
Early detections. I was diagnosed in stage 1. Early detection truly saved lives.
And with the race, do you have like booths and tables set up with that kind of information, or more importantly, with those kind of advocates manning the tables?
Yeah, absolutely. There's so many different aspects as far as how the race looks like and what it all entails, but that is a big part of it, is there's different areas for breast cancer survivors, for getting information. There's another aspect called I Am the Cure, where people can learn about the different sort of testing and things that are going on that they can actually become a part of in order to hopefully get to that point where we find that cure and that end to breast cancer.
Awesome, awesome. And so your advocacy work includes a plethora of things, I'm assuming, not just the race though, right?
Oh, yes. Yes, it does. I'm part of the Race Planning Committee, and you will find me on most weekdays anywhere where I can get a group of women to talk to about the BCCP program. I'm usually set up in local Walmarts, Walgreens, health fairs, beauty shops, churches, just trying to get the word out, trying to encourage women to talk about it among themselves and in the congregations about this wonderful service that we offer, because so many women suffer in silence. You know, they don't do anything about it, and it's fear. And you get a certain segment that they don't want to know. You know, they don't want to do the screening.
Thank you guys for joining us. We're going to talk more about this when we have our next guest after this commercial.
So scared of his return that I can't sleep tonight in this hospital.
We have three beautiful children, and everything you do or say to me, they take pictures with their minds, and I want to put a stop to that.
Sometimes I have thoughts of killing you. You know that?
Go ahead. You're doing me a favor.
Alex was the only one that knew the secrets.
Boy, why don't you leave that girl alone before you mess around and get her pregnant?
Why do you have so many boyfriends?
They all treat me nice.
When they ever treated you to anything? Only time they come around here is when they want one thing.
No! No!
You eat so damn much, why can't you choke on something? You're just a fat, disgusting excuse for a kid, and I ought to smack you!
I should have died instead. They were right.
No, you have. Life is worth living.
I have every type of abuse in there.
Yeah. Verbal, physical, sexual, mental.
You name it, it's in that room.
You see, after years of abuse, you lose yourself.
Miss Vivica. Miss Vivica.
Cause this time, it's the last time, I know that my eyes have seen too much.
I know you've been through some hell and high water, but I see a turnaround right now. You will be silent no more.
Stress, depression, and severe mental illness can happen to anyone. Team Mental Health Services has been helping those struggling with these conditions in southeastern Michigan. Within 24 hours of reaching out to our team, members receive psychiatric evaluations and begin the necessary treatment for recovery. Team Mental Health Services prides itself on going the extra mile for its members.
And it was towards the sixth court date. I finally stood up and said, I can handle this process the rest of the way. And it was all because of the motivation and encouragement I got from Team Mental Health staff.
Team Mental Health Services, because we care and you can.
Welcome back to My Healthy Mind. We're joined with Catherine Nichols, Doctor of Nursing Practice at Carmanos Cancer Center. Welcome.
Thank you.
And Doctor, can you help us with some wellness tips for women to help prevent cancer?
Oh, sure. That's one of the best conversations I can have with my women as to how to prevent cancer from starting in the first place. And there are a lot of things we can do as women to help, prevent cancer. And I know that, people talk about these things all the time. You know, not drinking. Alcohol has been associated with the development of breast cancer, as is an increased body weight and a sedentary lifestyle. All of those things are associated and have been proven to increase the rate of breast cancer development. So diet, exercise, not smoking, limiting your alcohol intake, doing those kinds of things, and of course getting a mammogram every year once you're 40. I know that the new guidelines are saying maybe every other year between the ages of 40 and 50. That's something that our women can discuss with their primary care providers to see if they should have one every year when they're 40, if they can start later in life. But we at Carmanos are still saying every year.
Dr. Nichols, what other screening should women get on a regular basis?
Well, being a nurse practitioner in the Women's Wellness Clinic at Carmanos, those are some things that I can walk my women through and make sure that they're taking care of themselves that way as well, not just, for breast cancer. Mm-hmm. Getting a pap smear regularly, new guidelines have changed on that as of this year about pap smears. If women have had one, a normal one, the last few, they can have a pap smear every 3 years, and the HPV testing can happen only once every 5 years now.
Wow.
Those are the new recommendations, which is nice for a lot of women. Getting their regular colonoscopies once they're 50, every 5 or 10 years, depending on their risk factors. Looking at skin issues and skin cancer, if they have a propensity to develop moles, and if they've been in the sun a lot, those kinds of things, they should be getting an annual full body skin check. So those are some things that we can talk about. In the Women's Wellness Clinic at Carmanos, we can actually offer them a pap smear if they need one.
Dr. Nichols, can you share a few quick tips for women to cultivate awareness in their lives?
Oh, sure. In addition to, diet and exercise and not smoking, limiting alcohol, mm-hmm. I suggest that women talk with their family members about any breast cancer or ovarian cancer that may be in their families. And talking with their primary care providers about possibly getting genetically tested if need be.
Excellent. Dr. Nichols, thank you for sharing such empowering information with our viewers of My Healthy Mind. We appreciate you coming today.
Well, thanks for the opportunity. Thank you.
Stress, depression, and severe mental illness can happen to anyone. Team Mental Health Services has been helping those struggling with these conditions in southeastern Michigan. Within 24 hours of reaching out to our team, members receive psychiatric evaluations and begin the necessary treatment for recovery. Team Mental Health Services prides itself on going the extra mile for its members.
And it was towards the sixth court date. I finally stood up and said, I can handle this process the rest of the way. And it was all because of the motivation and encouragement I got from Team Mental Health staff.
Team Mental Health Services, because we care and you can.
The people here actually care about you and your future and what you become after you graduate high school.
Loyola's mission is to turn out good young men.
Loyola is a place to help us grow.
A smaller setting and more one-on-one.
Give you that one-on-one attention that you don't normally get.
Making sure that the student is taken care of spiritually, educationally, and physically.
I focus more at this school than I did all my other schools.
By the time they get to about the 10th or 11th grade, they're basically bonded like brothers.
If you're looking for a brotherly love or someone to lean on or get in touch with and talk to personally, this school is the perfect place to go.
Welcome back to My Healthy Mind. I'm Elizabeth Atkins, and this is my co-host, Michael Hunter. Now it's time to hear from our viewers. Remember, we want to hear from you, so please email us at myhealthymind.com, send us a tweet on Twitter, or contact us on Facebook. Michael, we have some questions. The first one comes from Ricky in Northville. He says he saw the show, he wants to get screening, but he's too afraid to go because he's afraid he might get a positive for cancer. What should he do?
Definitely get screened. One of the things that we learned from our guest today is that early detection is what can save your life. So you want to make sure that the fear of a bad result does not overwhelm you enough where you don't get screened. Because early detection is where you get the highest probability of successful recovery. So make sure, if you didn't take anything away from today, is definitely get screened, and get screened very, very early. And we have another question from Tammy on Twitter.
Okay.
Oh, it says, is it too late to register for Race for the Cure?
Oh, great question, Tammy. Our guest, Brian Christie, who's co-chair of Race for the Cure this year, said you can register for Race for the Cure right up to the moment that the race starts on Saturday morning at Jefferson and Shane Park. So lace up your shoes and get down there and run for a good cause and have a great time.
So, Elizabeth, what did you take away from today's show with today's guest?
I found that their message of getting screenings on a regular basis was extremely inspiring and powerful, because it's so easy, if you're feeling good, thinking, oh, I don't need that. But you do need that, because you might not have any symptoms of something deadly that could be occurring inside your body.
Absolutely. And one of the things that struck me was the number of people who had passed away and who were associated with Ms. Watkins as far as having cancer,
yes.
But more importantly, her survival,
yes.
And the number of survivors that are out there, and the number of people that are really trying to tell their stories so that more victims will not succumb to this particular disease.
So they can be survivors.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And I think that the race is a phenomenal way to bring so many people together and get so many people behind such a good cause.
Yes. I've done the race before, and it's big fun. I mean, it's a very important cause, but it's fun to be out there amongst 25 or 30,000 people running together. It's like a sea of pink. It's phenomenal.
Yes, and so if you haven't been there, this is a great opportunity to do so. And when you think about what we're going to do beneficially,
yes.
How can you not go? How can you
right.
not participate?
Right.
And I think our guest did a very good job of teaching that to us today.
Yes. Yes.
So that, you know, we can definitely put a dent and hopefully a cure one day.
Yes, and we're going to put the resources that can help you connect with more information on our website, myhealthymind.com.
And thank you for viewing with us today. Again, myhealthymind.com, Twitter, Facebook, reach out to us, and we will do our best to answer your questions in a great manner. So tune in next time on My Healthy Mind.